If you're even a little bit of a gamer, you've probably heard of Roblox, a website which has millions of games that you can play. However, in this video, I'll be talking about only one of the mini games, Waterloo at Home. What is it? Waterloo at Home is a Napoleonic War era game where the whole point is to battle. There is 2 teams and 8 classes, which we will talk about later. Without further ado, let's get into the video. As said before, there is 2 teams, red and blue, plus the doppelganger in green, but that's not fucking important. Both of these teams fight against each other for ground, and to destroy others' forts. However, there is times where nothing is happening at all, and it's just a dummy war or something.
Them! Fight them!
You know what?
Usually, each attack is comprised of a battle, which is a term in-game for when mass amounts of players clash against each other, whether it be against a fort or in just in a field.
Oh, would you rather have a banana or a split banana? Or a banana split?
A banana.
And why?
I'd rather have a split banana.
Well, I'd rather have a full banana because, if I don't feel like eating it, I could play with it.
I don't understand what the
Every time you attack a fort, the main goal is to destroy the flag in order to stop the enemies fighting and completely tear down the fort. After this, a sapper can replace the fort with their own team's fort.
Come on! We have Jesus on our side! We have Jesus on our side! What the heck is shooting at us?
Take it to fort. The fort is ours. Where's the Walmart flag? We need the Walmart. We need Walmart. Yes, the Walmart army is taking it over. Walmart is the only military I trust.
Forts can comprise of many defenses, which include traps, trenches, spikes, and obstacles. Many men who defend defiantly, and the central flag that allows enemies to attack directly by spawning.
Snack.
Get into their fort! Get into their fort! Ah! What cannons
Snack.
Are beating me?
Snack.
They're shooting cannons at us, the other fort!
Snack!
Watch out! Oh my god.
Snack!
Oh my god.
Oh no, Snack.
He's trying to shoot at us. Oh my god, he's digging into the ground. He's digging in. He's digging in.
Heck.
Get in here.
United States Forces!
I got freaking killed by the canister! I'm gonna shoot your fort now. I'm gonna run away.
No, but... I have the no snack. Snack! Snack!
There's so much canister in them, so I just need to kill them.
Snack! I got the supply of snack!
Don't worry, I'm trying to reload. Oh my god. Ground shot directly at us. This is terrifying. Oh my god, watch out for the round shot!
While each battle goes on, each class has its own uses and advantages during these battles. Without any delay, let's talk about the different classes in this next stage. The Ranker. The Ranker is the backbone class of every single battle within Waterloo at home. Armed with a musket, which bears a bayonet, it is the best all-around class and can be fairly useful in attacking enemy forts and charging enemy troops. This class is the all-time best starting class for anybody who doesn't know how to play the game. Flag Bearers. The most important supporting class within the game. Flag Bearers carry a flag, a sword, and a pistol, but nothing is a more important tool to a flag bearer than the flag. The flag allows allies to spawn on them. This can keep a battle going when losses become high. Therefore, this class requires someone who knows how to stay alive and how to think on their feet. Artilleryman. This support class is a fairly important component within the game. Usually, artillerymen do not partake directly in the battle, but are good at assisting men at sieging a fort. They do this by bombarding the enemy with a variety of armaments. This class requires trial and error to figure out once you start playing it. But an experienced artilleryman will know how to aim their weapons true and bombard an enemy into submission. The list of weapons they use comprises of a rocket launcher, a cannon, a howitzer, a mortar, and a Gatling gun, each of which have their own special uses in battle. The Musician. More of a meme than a true supportive class, this support class takes the use of music to provide morale. The morale boost for the musicians is fairly small compared to having a flag around. But if there are no alternatives, it can be useful to regain morale. Cavalry. Cavalry is a main infantry class, which carries a sword and rides on a horse. This class excels at attacking groups of infantry, while avoiding being shot by using their speed to their advantage. This class can be of the utmost annoyance if you are up against an experienced cavalryman. Experienced cavalry will know how to time their hits in order to kill their rival. Medic. The Medic is a truly important support class, which can heal troops who have been injured. Despite their usefulness, they are only truly useful when dealing with weapons that don't just one-shot an enemy, such as swords and a Gatling gun, as long as you don't get directly hit. Not only can they heal someone directly, but they can drop a supply box of bandages for soldiers to grab. Captain. The Captain is a class that doesn't truly fall into any category. The Captain spawns ships that have cannons on them which artillerymen can fire. The usual loadout for a Captain is a spyglass, pistol, sword, and many other items that I cannot remember. The ships that can be spawned vary in size, and armament, and the only way to get other ships is unknown to me, actually. Truly, the only true role of the Captain is to bombard enemy positions from the water, carry allies and bring them to land, and to attack other enemy ships. The Sapper. The Sapper is by far the most bully class in this game. People do not respect these builders. Every time they go to bed, they cry themselves to sleep. Every fort they build, they cry in the corners of, as they are torn down by enemy forces. They are always yelled at, no matter the situation or how many materials they have. Their life is a living hell! But they have their uses. Uses that put them second behind the flag bearer. And they deserve plenty of respect for this. They make the forts that provide frontline positions for men who want to attack the enemies, make traps for enemies that attempt to raid forts, build trenches that can be used to stay safe during attack, have a variety of anti-cavalry fortifications, are the only ones that can build cannons for artillerymen, and also help sieging forts by building ladders over their walls. A truly necessary class for any game. The Sharpshooter. The Sharpshooter is basically just a ranker that carries a rifle. Would not suggest using ever. I would just stick to using the ranker, which is way better. The Grenadier. The Grenadier is an infantry class which has a grenade, carbine, and briquet. This class excels at destroying groups of enemies and forcing enemies out of hiding using their grenades. This game for me was a really fun game to play. Despite this, hackers usually run rampant within it. Due to this fact, I rate the game an 8 out of 10. I hope you guys enjoyed this explanation of the game. I hope you guys have learned not to yell at sappers and yell at them what to do. I hope you realize that rankers are way better than sharpshooters. And I hope you've learned that sieging forts is really hard. Oh, and musicians?
Nah, fuck 'em. They ain't that important.